This is the fifth video to help you learn programming designed specifically for the computer science principal course. In this video, we're looking at procedures which are called functions in Python. So we're going to define a function, call a function, pass parameters, and do return. Also, we'll look at some pseudocoding examples. So what do we mean by procedures? What do we mean by functions? Well, they're exactly the same thing. Just procedure is the name used in pseudocode and function is the name used in Python. So procedure is a function. Function is a procedure. So what are the benefits of using these procedures or functions? Well, here you see a lot of code. This code has seven temperatures and it changes them from Fahrenheit to Celsius. And here's the output. Now we highlighted here the seven temperatures. The rest of the code is the same. We can take that code out. Now wouldn't it be easier if we just copied that code for each temperature? So here we've got the same code, but there's errors. You can see there's a lot of code and it's difficult to find the errors. But when we actually just have the code once, then it's very easy to spot the error and change it. So the benefits of using this code once means that we have to write less code, we've got less chance of mistakes, they're easier to find, the code's easy to change or maintain, or change and maintain, and we've written that code once and then we can use it as many times as we like. So that's why we like functions, otherwise called as procedures. So let's look at these in code. Here we have a Python function. You can see it's quite similar to what we've seen before, and this one just prints hello. Now what parts are in this function? We start off with define using def. Then we've got a function name. Then we've got some round brackets. We've got a colon. Underneath we've got some code which is indented. So for example here we've got print hello. So this function will call hello, but it needs to be called. So let's call a function. So here we've got our code again. But underneath you see we've got the function name print me. That calls the function. So we've got the function name and we've got the round brackets again. So that's how we call a function. And that prints hello. We can print hello hello by calling the function twice. If we call it three times, we print hello hello hello. But it means that we can call a function many times and we can repeat the function many times. So you can remember our example at the start. That's how we can use functions. What about passing parameters? Let's look at our code again with our function. And we can change it. So now we've got hello in the brackets when we call the function. And that passes to the function, which then prints it. So we're passing this hello, which is a parameter, to the function. You can see we pass the hello to the m, which is in the brackets after the function name, which is then printed. So that's passing a parameter. Here, hello is in a variable called message. Again, we can pass that message as a parameter in the brackets to the function. Here we've got 7 and 8. Again, we can pass these to the function, both of them in the brackets to x and y, and then print them. That prints 7 and 8. Here we've got 3 parameters. Doesn't matter how many, we pass 3 when we call the function and we receive 3 inside the function. There we go. So looking at our example, our code we can put in a function, we repeat it, but we want to use that function, but we want to give it a temperature a different temperature every time we call it. So we need to pass the Fahrenheit temperature. So let's have a look at this. Here's our code. We can run this and it prints the temperature in Celsius. 90 degrees Fahrenheit is 32.2 degrees Celsius. Now we want to put that in a function. So we define, give a function name, and we call it. So that works the same. But the Fahrenheit temperature is inside the function. We don't want it there. So let's move that outside, and then we've got our parameter, which is the Fahrenheit temperature, temp underscore F, and we pass that to the function. So the code still runs the same, and the output is the same, but now we've got the variable of the Fahrenheit temperature outside of the function. You can see we move that, we pass that from the function call to the function. So now, with a week's worth of temperatures, we can just call the function seven times and it prints our seven temperatures. So that's a lot better than what we started off with. So just to show you, this is the code for the function. We've highlighted the parameter temperature underscore F. Now, there is a slightly better way that we can call that, because we're calling it seven times. We can use a for loop. So here, for each value that's in the week, we can call the calc Celsius and that prints our output. So that's a lot less code than we started off with. We can also return a value. Again, we start with a simple example, but here, instead of printing hello, we return it and then print it after. So when we call the function, we're expecting something to be returned back. So we can see here, we've got the hello, and then we pass that back to the variable m, which is then printed. So that prints hello. We could make hello a variable, and again we return the variable x, that value goes to m, and that will print hello as well. Here we've got a function called doubler, which doubles an integer. So here, doubler, the 5 is passed up to the function. So now x equals 5, that times 2 is 10, that's returned to y, print y equals 10. So here, doubler doubles what's passed to that function. Let's look at some examples. We've got sum of numbers. 5 and 9 are put in, and out comes 14, which is the sum of 5 and 9. 5 and 9 go into the function called squares, and out comes 25 and 81. Sum of squares, 5 and 9 go in, 106 comes out. Here, 5 and 9 go in, subtract numbers, and minus 4 is returned. So let's have a look at the code for these examples. Here we've got sum of numbers. This passes 5 and 9, added together, passed back, prints 14. Squares returns the square of x and the square of y, the square of 5 and the square of 9. So that prints 25 and 81. Sum of squares adds these two together and returns the sum of the squares. So that prints 106. And subtract numbers, you might have guessed it, 5 minus 9 equals minus 4. So that's returned and then printed. So these are examples in Python. So we call them functions. But in pseudocode, they're called procedures. So let's have a look at them in procedures. We've got the Python code of a simple function that's been called. And here's the pseudocode. We've got procedure, we've got the procedure's name, the round brackets, we've got the curly brackets, and then we have the code inside. Underneath, the procedure is called with the procedure name and the brackets. So very similar to the Python. Here we're passing a parameter in Python, and here we've got the same code but in pseudocode. Remember, it's called the procedure. Here we return a value. Again, we use the word return in pseudocode. So the pseudocode is quite similar, but again, We call the function a procedure. So we use the word procedure rather than define. So let's have a look at some examples. Here we've got a procedure called calc area that multiplies the length and height together and then displays the area. Remember, when you're calling the procedure, we've called it here and it's two values, 8 and 9, two parameters. So there must be two because we've got length and height when we define, or when we have the procedure calc area, it's waiting for two things, length and height, two parameters. So when we call it, we must call it with two, 8 and 10 in this example. And here we've got some code on the left, and you might be asked how we can change that. So instead of repeating code, we can put it in a procedure. So here we've created a procedure called calc sum, and that just adds two numbers together and displays the total. So we've got x and y, and we've called calc sum, changed x, called it again, changed y, called it again. So this is the way how we can change repeated code to code in a procedure. Okay, if you learned something there, please click the like, and if you want to follow along with this series, please subscribe, and then you'll be notified when the videos are released.